Hello guys, welcome to my channel HVR Tutorials. In this video, we will discuss about XPath operators and XPath functions. So basically, what is meant by an operator? An operator is a symbol that can perform mathematical and logical operations. Okay, so if you see here, these are the operators that we can use while writing XPath. So here, these operators are divided into two categories. One is mathematical operators, the other one is logical operators. So I think you already know what is the functionality of these mathematical or logical operations, because if you come across any programming language, you would be using these things there, right? So now let me tell you how we use these things while writing an XPath. So let me just open the Google Chrome. So here I'm using this website, guys. That is my own website, that is HVR Tutorials. Okay. So in that we have a menu. Just go to Selenium Practice and click on XPath Practice. So this page I'm going to use for the practice today. So let me just click on F12. So first we'll see what are the mathematical operators. Okay. So here I have a table. Okay. In the table, I have a salary column and it displays some salary values, right? So what I wanted to do is I wanted to identify these cells based on the salary value. Okay. So just let me write the XPath here. So here I'm going to write in a relative XPath. So I'm going to use double slash. So first I will inspect this element here first. So the tag name is TD, okay? And the text is this 5000. In our earlier video, we have already seen how we can handle attributes in the XPath, but we haven't seen how we can handle text in the XPath, right? So if you want to find out or get the text, then you can use a method called text, okay? So that will be giving you this text value. Okay. So TD text equal 5000. Okay. So now if you see here, it says 1 of 2 and it is identifying this one and the other one is this one. Right. So now we got two values. That means two elements. Okay, so now we'll see another operator, that is like less than. Okay, so here if you see less than 5000, how many elements are there? 2000, 3000, 1000. So if you see in the bar, it says 1 of 3. That means we got 3 elements, right? You can see we got 3 elements. So this is how you can use the mathematical operators, guys. So the next one is logical operators. So where exactly we are going to use this logical operators? Basically, if you want to find out an element using an XPath, we are going to write one condition, right? So if your element is not becoming unique with that one condition, then what you will do? You will add one more condition, right? So how you are going to add that condition? If you are adding one condition, that is fine. But if you are adding more than one condition, how you are adding those conditions? We are going to use one of these logical operators to combine multiple conditions. Okay, so let's see what is this OR and what is this AND and how we use them. Okay, so basically the OR is like if you are passing multiple conditions, all conditions need not to be true. If any of the one condition is true also, the condition will be satisfied and the element will be returned. Okay, so first we'll see OR. Okay, so here I have some buttons. Okay, so let me inspect this refresh button. So here you can see the refresh button has a type attribute, name attribute and value attribute. So I want to identify this button using these attributes. So I will use OR condition here now. Okay, so the tag name is input. I'll just inspect this again and you can see the name is refresh button. So let me give name and value also. Okay. So first I will identify individually. If you see, by using name, I have identified this element and it is identifying 1 of 1. That means this element is a unique element now. Okay. So next I will give this value also. You can see by using value also, this element is identified uniquely. So I'm going to combine using OR condition. So here I'm telling the browser, like, get me an input tag where name equal refresh button or value equal refresh. So if any of this is true, it will give me this one. Okay. So for example, I will change the name to something. YOI. Okay. Still I'm able to get this one. How? Because this condition is true. This condition is false, but this condition is true. So that is why I'm able to get this value. Okay. So similarly, if you change this refresh to some other, still I'm able to get it, right? Because the first condition is true. Now the second is false. So that is how this OR condition works. Okay. So the next one is logical AND. So how we use this logical AND? So for example, in the existing XPath only, let me show you how this logical AND works. Okay. So if I put a logical AND here, I'm able to get the value because both the conditions are true. If you are using logical AND, then whatever the condition count you are using here, all those conditions must return the true. Okay. Then only the XPath will be validated. Okay. So if you see here, this one and this one both are returning true. That is why I'm getting this element. So if I change something here, you can see this name is not available. Okay. With this name, there is no input tag. So that is why I'm not getting the value. You can see 0 of 0. So the second one is still true, but the first one is false. So it is not returning me any element. Okay. So this is how logical AND works. So the next one is XPath functions. Okay. I have listed few XPath functions here, which will be used mostly in our applications. So that is text contains starts with normalize space. So we have already seen this text method, right? So the next one is contains. Okay. So in these three methods, we have an option to use either attribute value or text. Okay. So now we'll see how we can use this contains method. Okay. So before that, first we'll see text method. Then we'll go to contains method. Okay. So here, if you see, I have one link here, sign into account. So I want to identify this based on the text. Okay. So the text is this one. I'm copying this one. So the tag name is A and text equal in single quotes. I'll pass this text. So now you can see the anchor tag is identified, right? So here, if you see, I have provided the exact text and I used text method. So if I remove this account from here, am I able to identify? No, because when you are using text method, it requires the exact text. Okay. So this exact text is not available. We are missing some text here. So that is the reason it is not returning me any element. Okay. So in this kind of scenarios, we can use contains method. If you want to verify or identify any element based on some portion of the text or partial text, then in that case, you can use contains method. Okay. So this is how we can write. The tag name is A contains. So I'm going to use the text. Okay. So I'll just remove the account from here. And I close this. Okay. See, now I am able to identify this one. Okay. How? Because now I used contains method. So it is verifying for the partial text. Okay. So when I say partial text, that text should be in the order. Okay. You cannot give something like this sign into. Okay. You might be thinking like, okay, sign is there and into is there. You cannot give something like that. It should be in the order, proper order. Okay. So sign in two. So this will be identified. Okay. So this contains method, not just for text. You can use the attribute values also. How? If you see this one. So this div is having some class, right? That is container. Okay. So now what I will do, I will use this one to find out by using this contains. So my tag name is div. So I'm going to pass only sign in here and let's see how it will identify. So now I'm going to pass the class as attribute and the text is sign in. Okay, and s is small. So you can see now it has identified, right? I'm not passing the entire class name here. I'm just passing a partial text, that is sign in, but still I'm able to identify this div class, right? So this is how we can use the attribute values also. It's not just for class. If you have other attribute, you can use that attribute also. So this contains and this starts with normalize space. These three methods you can use for text or attribute values also. Okay. So similarly, like just like contains, the starts with method also works. But the difference is in the contains method, we can take any partial text. Like it might be in the middle, or it might be in the ending, or it might be in the starting, right? But when it comes to start with, you can send the partial text, but that partial text should be starting text. Okay, it cannot be ending, or it cannot be in the middle one. Okay, so let's see. So now we will identify the same one. Okay, this sign into account one, but this time I'm going to use only till here, sign in. Okay, double slash, that is anchor tag, so A, and starts with, so I'll set text, comma, in quotes, I will paste this one. So you can see, now it is identifying this element. Okay, so what if I just remove this one, sign? So now I'm not getting this one, right? Why? Because this in is not the starting text. Okay, the starting text is sign in. So that is the reason I'm not able to identify the element. So now I'm able to identify. If you use the contains method, it can be a partial text in that complete text. So it can be a starting one, middle one, or ending one. But if you are using the starts with method, it should be starting with that one. Okay. So the last one is normalize space. Okay. So what is this normalized space? So for example, in some situations, you will try to pass some text, but the text may have some spaces in the starting and in the ending. Okay, so let me show you. So if I inspect this first name, so this first name is having some space in the ending, right? So in these situations, how you are going to identify these elements? You cannot write your XPath with this space also, right? So how are you going to do that? Further, we have a method called normalized space. Okay. So what it will do, it will remove the starting and ending spaces. That means leading and trailing spaces. Okay. It will not remove the middle spaces. For example, if you see here between first and name, we have a space. So that space will not be removed. But if you have any spaces before first, and if you have any spaces after name, those spaces can be removed. Okay. So let me show you. First, let me inspect this element. First name. So the tag name is label. So I'll write normalize space, and I'm going to use the text method. Okay. So equal to. Okay. So you can see I haven't provided any space here, but still I'm able to identify it. How? Because of this normalize space method. Okay. So here it is just one space. But some scenarios, it might be like more than one. Okay. So it's not a good practice to provide those spaces also in the XPath, right? So that is not a good practice. That is the reason we can use normalized space, and which removes the trailing and leading spaces. So you can simply pass the normal text itself here. Okay. So this is about XPath operators and functions, guys. So I suggest you to practice these things. If you want to be perfect in writing the XPath, then definitely you should know all of these things. Okay. So please practice these things. If you have any comments or if you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.
I hope you enjoyed this session. If you like this video, please hit the like button and also share it with your friends. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.